Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Nags checklist where I'm going to discuss about list of things you need to consider for improving the performance of your Power BI report. Before talking about the list, if you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin with our first list. And one important aspect of it is, like, this list is mostly suited for import mode. This is not a list that suits for direct or live connection. And with this note, let's begin. The first and simplest checklist you need to do is, like, remove the unnecessary columns or rows. Columns is, everyone understand that most of the columns, whatever used in the report, you can use it, and remaining columns you can remit. What about rows? So if possible, like, there are certain years or some kind of locations that is not at all used, right? It may be you need to check with the user. Some rows it will not be useful, right? It mostly the rows filtration applicable for the historical data. Only the latest 2 years, 3 years data is enough for the reporting. Just load those. That is what I meant here, the rows. The next is, like, make your data aggregation or group by a summarized column. Instead of directly loading the data in a table like that contains 10,000 or 20,000, I mean 10 million or 20 million records, you try to do the aggregation. I have already taken two videos regarding that, how you can aggregate your data. Like, from the 10 million records, you can make it to 1 million, or based on the number of records you have, you can reduce the size of rows using the aggregation or group by columns. Just go and watch in this two videos how to do that. Then there comes another important aspect that most people are not aware, or they don't do it. Like, try to optimize the column data types. You need to properly set the data type, and whenever there are possibilities, you can convert the text columns to numerical columns. So if some numerical column is classified as text, try to change it to numerical. And in this example, I have explained some of the things. Like, you can see here, the receipt number is classified as text here, and you try to remove these two characters from this receipt number because it's going to be no use with the prefix, right? You can remove it and store it. Obviously, if this receipt number is referred in some other table, you need to do the transformation over there as well. Doing so, your model size will be drastically reduced compared to storing the data like this, right? Remove this ln from the columns, then you can reduce the size of your model. That will improve the performance. Then the fourth checklist, what are the things you can do is, like, disable the Power Query load. Like, a lot of people will do some kind of transformations, and they require some tables to be imported here for lookup or some kind of transformations they do. And that table is not required in the modeling part. This I'm talking about a Power Query layer. And so the tables that is not used in your reports or modeling, then you need to disable it. So just right click the table and uncheck these two boxes. Then this particular table will not be loaded in the modeling layer. This will be used only during the Power Query layer. So this is another important factor you need to consider. Then one last thing you can do is, like, disable auto date and time. A lot of people don't do it, but definitely if you do this change, like, it will drastically improve the performance. What it does is, like, the Power BI by default, how many date columns you have in your table, I mean in a table you have 3 to 4 date columns. For each for each column as considered as date, it will create internally a temporary date table. So it will be a huge storage if you have a huge volume of data. So for that, you can disable that one. And you need to have a proper date dimension once you disable it to make it properly work in your time engine intelligence functions. So you just disable auto date time options over here. So these are the some of the checklists that mostly I use to prefer or most of the people in the industry will follow. If you have some more checklists that you are doing in your organization, let us know or put it in our comments. We will try to update it or it will benefit others. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.